BQ's back, baby, and this is a pit stop on my quest for 300 Pennsylvania birds. Hit the music!
This is Birding with BQ. Living hard to bird hard. All the time.
We are live behind the Philadelphia Airport here in beautiful Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, as we're scanning the mudflats of the Delaware River in search of some shorebirds. As we approach low tide, we have mudflats here, we have mudflats there, but the mudflats we want to see the most are all the way out there at Little Tinicum Island in the Delaware River. So at the beginning of 2019, I made a Birding New Year's resolution to grow my Pennsylvania life list to 300 species by the end of the year. So how am I doing, you may ask? Well, I've added 9 species to my Pennsylvania list this year, bringing my grand total up to 298. I don't know what's more impressive, the list of birds that I got to see this year, or the fact that I'm able to hold the scope with no hands. Mudflats are starting to develop here at Little Tinicum Island. I'm out here to scan these mudflats in the rain, not because I have a rare bird alert I'm going after, but because I want to be at the right place and the right time in the event an American golden plover or a Barred sandpiper were to drop in. But that, folks, is unlikely. In fact, I have a less than 1% chance of seeing American golden plover, Barred sandpiper, or any of these target species that I have on my needs alert for eBird in Pennsylvania. The challenge I'm up against is something that many birders face, and that is that when you've been birding an area, whether it's a state or a county, for a long period of time, you've seen so many birds that it becomes increasingly harder to find new ones. And if an American golden plover or a Bayard sandpiper were to show up here in Pennsylvania, this would be a pretty decent place to find them, at least in Philadelphia, because you can see this mudflat area here is quite considerable and attracts a lot of bird activity. Uh-oh, my scope just took a tumble. Right here on the riverbank, right in that hole. But the good news is that it looks like we're still working. Woo! Double-crested cormorant taking a swim in front of Little Tinicum Island. My scope now officially smells due to this river rot. But hey, scope, I still love you. Great times together. Unfortunately, the viewing is less than spectacular because of how far the mudflats are, but the birds are still identifiable, like the red bill you can see of this Caspian tern among ring-billed gulls. So I could sit at home and wait for a rare bird alert to come across, or I can make my own destiny by going out to suitable habitat for species I have yet to see in Pennsylvania and patrol them. Any way you slice it, though, the odds are against me. So I'm not much of a gambler, but even when the odds are stacked this high, nothing. The heck's that? A black and white warbler on a log right here on the edge of the river. How cool. As I was saying, when it comes to goal setting and taking on new challenges, nothing beats betting on yourself. So on this wager, I'm going all in on my quest for 300 Pennsylvania birds. Can it be done? Tell me what you think. And until next time, stay fresh and peace out, y'all.